Hi guys, I welcome you all to the claim lecture series. Now this claim lecture series includes concepts lessons for agriculture through important MCQs, and this particular video lecture is important for NABARD grade A exam and AFO IBPS exam. Both are going to be held in 2019. And this particular video is about the agroecological zones, and since this is part 2, we have already covered AEZs in part 1 as well. In case you guys have missed that, just go back and see that video as well. So let us just proceed with the lecture. Okay, so before proceeding, let me just quickly tell you about the courses which are offered by EduTap. So we have the NABARD Grade A course for 2019 examination. Now see, this is a full video course which will cover your phase 1 as well as phase 2. It has various MCQs, worksheets and all the summary sheets. Since agriculture is a very important part and it is asked in phase 1 as well as phase 2. And for IBPS AFO, which has agriculture component in phase 2, we are offering a test series. And for knowing more about these two courses, you can just go to our website. And here are the various other courses which are related to RBI, SEBI and NABARD as well. You can just see the courses here and you can even visit our website. Okay, so our very first MCQ from this video lecture is about the length of growing period of the crops in the eastern coastal plains. So you can just go through the options if you guys can answer it. Otherwise, you'll be able to answer it after this video definitely. Okay, and our next question is again about the soils, like agroecological zones contain red and lateritic soil. So which of these is the agroecological zone? So you have your options given. And try to answer this question if you can. And our third question is it's a very simple question. Agroecological zones are divided into how many subzones? See, as we've already covered the agroecological zones and three ecosystems in the earlier part, so you guys must be able to answer this question. So let us just move on. Okay, so let us just see first of all what we have covered in our previous lectures. So we have covered agroclimatic zones, you know, that is important for us. So this we have already covered, and agroecological zones were, the lecture was particularly a kind of continuation to that zone. In case you guys have missed that video, just go back and see that as well. Then we covered how many agroclimatic zones are there and the specifications we discussed. And finally, in our previous part, we have learned what is agroecological zones, which body was responsible for this, what was the need for carving out agroecological zones from the agroclimatic zones. And since we know that agroecological zone has six ecosystems which are broadly divided, so we already covered these three ecosystems, that is arid, semi-arid and semi-humid. So let us now see about our three other ecosystems, and all these must be clear to you guys from now. Okay, so our fourth ecosystem, as we've already covered three earlier, our fourth ecosystem is humid perhumid ecosystem. Now see, the ecoregion, that is the kind of climate, the bioclimate is there, is hot subhumid to warm perhumid. As we've already known that perhumid is the climate which has excess humidity. So the ecoregion is here hot subhumid to warm perhumid. And the length of growing period, as we know that it is very important for any agroecological zone. The determining factor is LGP, we have already seen that. So more or less for all these systems in this particular humid perhumid zone, it is 210 days. So this is again important. You need to understand that LGP and the ecoregion and particularly the soil type are three important parameters from your examination point of view. So let us see now what is your first zone under the humid perhumid ecosystem. So your first zone is Bengal and Assam plains. Now see, we have already covered, we have seen what were the zones earlier, till 14 we have covered. So this is our 15th zone, and it broadly consists of the states of West Bengal and Assam. And we have seen that alluvium derived is the most fertile soil, as it is derived from the alluviums which are usually brought over by the rivers. So this is your Bengal and Assam plains. And our next zone is Eastern Himalayas. So Arunachal Pradesh, Sikkim and part of West Bengal. So let me just tell you, the part of West Bengal is Darjeeling, which is involved in the Eastern Himalayas. And here the soil kind is brown and red hill. So as this is usually the hilly area, so the soil here is red and brown soil. And a third particular system under humid perhumid zone is the Northeastern Himalayas. Now see, these are also known as the Purvanchal Himalayas. So they have the particularly states Tripura, Mizoram and Meghalaya. Meghalaya is the states which has Garo Khasi Jaintia Hills. So this is the most rainiest state, we can say, and the soil here is red and lateritic soil. So this is again important for us to know the kind of soil which is present in the regions given. Okay, so our fifth and important ecosystem is the coastal ecosystem. Now see, coastal ecosystem, as you know, that the peninsular India has two coasts. That is one which is lying to the side of Arabian Sea, it is known as the west coast, and the other coast which is lying to the side of Bay of Bengal is your eastern coast. So first of all, let's see about eastern coastal plains. Now the states covered are the states which are near to the Bay of Bengal. So these are Tamil Nadu, Puducherry, then comes Andhra Pradesh, Odisha and West Bengal. Now see, the ecoregion here is particularly hot, subhumid to semi-arid. So not only humid, we can say, due to the presence of this Bay of Bengal here, but also it is arid. And the soil type is coastal alluvium derived. Now see, although it is alluvium derived, but it is coastal. So we can say it is not as fertile as it is in the Assam and Bengal plains. And the length of growing period again here is 90 to 210 days. This is also important for you guys. And our 19th region is Western Ghats and Coastal Plains. So the states broadly covered here are, they start from the Kerala and they go up to the Daman and Diu. So these are your important states, Kerala, Goa, Maharashtra, Gujarat and Daman and Diu. So here the climate is hot, perhumid. And the soil again here is a mixture of red soil, lateritic soil and alluvium derived soil. So these are the important soils with the LGP, that is the length of growing period, which is more than 210 days. So this is the stark difference which you need to note down, that eastern coastal plains and western ghat plains have different LGPs. You must not get confused in their LGPs. Okay, and our last and final ecosystem, which is again very important, is the island ecosystem. Now see, as India has two group of islands, which are Andaman Nicobar Islands and Lakshadweep. Andaman Nicobar lies in the Bay of Bengal and Lakshadweep at the Arabian Sea. So this is our 20th and final agroecological zones. We have already discussed these things. You guys must be able to remember that there are 20 agroecological zones which are basically carved out from the agroclimatic zones. The responsibility was given to the ICAR. And they have further given this responsibility to the LBS body, which we have discussed. So let us see about the states. It has to be union territory. So Andaman Nicobar and Lakshadweep, these are the two UTs which are covered here. And the ecoregion here is hot, humid, perhumid. So that means it is humid as well as perhumid at times. And the soil type is red, loamy and sandy. So let me just tell you that loamy soil is the particular soil which consists of clay and organic matters. So this soil is also considered as particularly the soil which is cultivable and fertile also. So even the bricks are made sometimes of the, apart from laterite, even loamy soil is useful there. And also we have to know that Lakshadweep is the region which has the forest cover. It comes in the top states and UTs with the forest covers, even the Andaman Nicobar. So this is about our 20th ecosystem. LGP is given here. It's more than 210 days. So moving on to the solution of our MCQs, which we have seen in the beginning of the lecture. So our first MCQ was, what is the length of the growing period of the crops in the eastern coastal plains? So as we have known that LGP is particularly important term, and for eastern coastal plains it is 90 to 210 days. So this is about our answer to this question. And our next question is, which of the following agroecological zones contains a red and lateritic soil? Now, this you guys must be able to answer. It's a direct question. So, Eastern Himalayas, Andaman Nicobar, Northeastern, Western Ghats or Eastern Coastal Plains? So, our answer is the Northeastern Himalayas or the Purvachal Himalayas. And our final question is again an easy question. Agroecological zones are divided into how many subzones? So answer to this question is 60 subzones. And yes, that's it. So now we have covered agroecological zones and agroclimatic zones both in two parts. And in case you guys have missed any of those videos, I recommend you to just go back and see those as well. And in case you guys have any query related to the courses which are offered by EduTap or the exams particularly, that is IBPS AFO specialist exam or the NABARD grade A exam, you can just visit our website www.edutap.co.in. Here is our ID, that is hello@edutap.co.in. You can drop us a mail here, and 8146207241 is a contact number. You can even WhatsApp us. And I hope this lecture was helpful for you guys in case you are preparing for particularly agrometeorology for the exam, that is NABARD grade A and IBPS AFO. And please do not forget to like, subscribe and share if you like this video. And please do note the link of the Telegram channel I have mentioned for you guys. It is also there in the description below. You can just go there and download the PDF of this particular lecture and all other lectures in particularly this series. And that's it guys. Thank you and have a happy learning.